Building a hempcrete house is more simple than conventional. It's three simple steps. So you have the structure that you have to build, which would be the skeleton of the house, and you build the body with the hempcrete, the insulation system, and then you have the skin, which is the lime plasters, the finishing parts. So no gypsum, no vapor barrier, no plastic in the walls. The hempcrete is an insulation system. So we can insulate the slabs, we can insulate the walls, we can insulate the roof and make the divisions. So it's not a structural material, but it's solid enough to hold its own weight. So hempcrete is a mix of a hemp hurd. So we use the interior of the straw of the hemp. So it's the hurd, and we need a binder, a natural glue, which is the lime. So lime is the binder, and it also preserves the natural fiber that we're using. So it makes a super durable material because it resists fire, resists mold, resists the vermin. So it will last, you know, for many generations. As long as there is a roof on the house, the hempcrete will stay. So why do we use hempcrete? You can see that it's beautiful. You know, we can shape it into any forms. We can make curves, we can make straight lines, you know, for contemporary design. It's healthy, I mean it's user-friendly for the people who's living in the houses, in those buildings made out of hempcrete. But it's also worker-friendly. We have to think of the workers sometimes. So very very easy to work with, very comfortable, you know, it smells good. It's not harmful at all. So and not for the workers, not for the users. It's also a good option because it's a regulator wall. So it regulates the temperature and regulates the humidity. You know, because it's very thick and porous, so it can take in, you know, humidity and release it. The R value of hempcrete is R2 per inch, R2.1 in fact. So we build walls that are 12 inch thick, it's R25. There's thermal mass in the hempcrete because the binder is lime, so a little bit of weight, you know, that brings to the hempcrete. So temperature will build up in the wall and slowly irradiate. So your temperature, humidity, very very stable through the whole year. You know, it performs well in the winter. It's very comfortable in the summertime. There's only one houses out of the 45 that we've done that has AC, you know, air conditioning. The mixes are prepared on site for the cast in place technique. We have the hurd, we have the lime binder on the site, and so we have someone preparing and making it perfect every time. He's like our baker. So it's we compare a lot of the recipes we have to a pastry or a bread recipes. Here we have the cast in place hempcrete technique. Just like how you pour the concrete into the formwork, that's a bit how we work. But hempcrete is very fibrous, very dry, so it cannot be poured in the formwork. It has to be placed and then tossed. We keep turning around the building, you know, filling up the forms, and once they're filled, we take off the forms and move them higher. So one team is on tossing the hemp, and we have another team working on the formwork. So we are basically molding the house into place. Cast in place hempcrete requires a lot of tools, you know, requires a lot of knowledge and experience. But we came up with a new way, you know, to make it more accessible, to reach out to more projects. The pre-formed, pre-dried hempcrete blocks. So we can use it in bricks as well. that would make it much more accessible. Two masons can build a hempcrete house in 2 weeks, you know, using the block. Cast in place hempcrete is the highest quality, but it's not how we can replace conventional building on a massive scale. If we want to make it a true solution and if we want to change the world, it has to be universal, you know, it has to fit everyone. So we cannot stick to hippie type of houses. We have to fit in conventional, we have to take it to modern building. Hempcrete is a little more expensive than conventional. It's about 20 to 30% higher. But it depends how much you can work on your house. So for some people, it's cheaper than conventional because they can provide labor and they can work a lot. For others, it's higher than conventional because they have to hire the team for the hempcrete and the lime plasters. There's not much disadvantage working with hempcrete. You know, the one that I can tell you about is the drying time. It doesn't take more time, you know, to build a hempcrete house than conventional, but the schedule is different. You have to integrate the drying times of hempcrete and the lime plasters. The most important thing about hempcrete, which makes it a revolutionary material, is that it catches more greenhouse gases than it will produce to harvest, process, transform, transport, put it into place. So most of the mass of the plant is carbon, and it's not coming from the ground, it's coming from the air, you know, as it takes in CO2, releases oxygen but keeps the carbon, so it builds up the body of the plant. So the carbon that is stocked, you know, in the hempcrete is not going back into the atmosphere. That's why I say it's a revolutionary material. It's much different, you know, than what we have in conventional. Petroleum industry is very huge and has a lot of power in the construction industry, so if they are the big tree, then we are the small axe, you know, we are slowly replacing all the petroleum, all the plastic in the industry by using natural materials.